This episode of DNews is brought to you by the US Air Force. Tiny robots of the future, we're gonna need tiny little batteries and tiny little cameras and tiny little motors, and the scientists of today are working on them right now. Howdy friends, Trace here, thanks for watching DNews. Futurist Ray Kurzweil, one of my favorite people to read about, has been quoted saying that in 25 years, the computer that's the size of your phone will be millions of times more powerful, but will be the size of a blood cell. And new nanoengineering is helping scientists build the robot which that computer could drive. At the moment when I think of like crazy robots, I think of like the DARPA Big Dog or Bina 48. But because of this new technique, future robots could be the size of specks of dust, or even smaller. Engineers in China and Australia have created a double-walled carbon nanotube motor. They first published their findings in the journal Nanotechnology and believe that this could be a big player in future nanodevices. We've talked about graphene before, a super strong one-atom thick sheet of carbon atoms. When you roll that graphene into a tiny tube, you get a carbon nanotube. Carbon nanotubes are exceptionally strong, but when you roll two that fit together, one inside the other, the engineers believe that a nanomotor could result. At the macro level, motors run when a magnetic device is spun inside of a tube of electrical wire. The current in the wire generates a magnetic flux, which pulls that inner magnet around, running the motor. But at the nano level, no way is that gonna work, Jack. You can't solder a wire into the outer tube at a nano level and run electricity. So instead, this double-walled carbon nanotube motor works because at the atomic level, there's the thing called the Vander Waals interaction. A Vander Waals interaction describes how atoms interact with each other due to electrical charge, which makes perfect sense when you're talking about a nanoscale motor. In this case, when the researchers put the two tubes together, these atomic forces caused the inner nanotube to start spinning. Then they had to figure out how to control that spin, because a spinning tube at a nano level doesn't really do much on its own. The researchers messed with the length of the outer tube to change the speed, and they found the ideal amount of space between the inner and outer tubes to encourage the best rotation. But in the end, the temperature turns out to be the keystone. At a fairly warm room temperature of about 300 Kelvin, they could get the motor to rotate the best. If they change the room temperature, they could also change the speed of the rotation. Obviously, their goal is to create a temperature-driven motor made of double-walled carbon nanotubes, so we will have to see where this goes. Nanoscale engineering isn't new, but the idea of making a nanomotor, that's pretty novel. Nano, by the way, means 10 to the negative 9th power, or 1/1 billionth of a meter. That's pretty small. Working at that scale requires extreme precision, and if engineers can master those skills, then it's only a matter of time before Ray Kurzweil's blood cell computer is put into a blood cell nano-electromechanical system. We could augment our immune systems, we could rebuild our bodies, we could even ingest new technologies. The future's gonna be a crazy place, and I am happy that scientists are keeping their eye on it. You know who else is always looking at the future? The brave men and women of the United States Air Force. American airmen are fueled by innovation, and every day they go above and beyond to break barriers both personally and professionally. So, a big shout out to the US Air Force for supporting DNews. What do you guys think of all this, though? Are you freaked out by the idea of a microscopic robot? Or are you super excited like I am? Let me know down in the comments. And if you want to know more about graphene and see maybe how it can help you charge your cell phone in 5 seconds, go over to this video down there and check that out. And make sure you subscribe to DNews. Thanks for watching, everybody.